Everybody lift your hands as we celebrate yes. the greatness of our God. He's great and he's greatly to be praised.
Yes, he is worthy to be praised. Yes.
My God is awesome.
My God is awesome.
He can move mountains.
Keep
me in the valley.
Keep me in the valley.
Hide me from the rain.
Hide me from the rain.
Come on, my God is awesome.
My God is awesome.
He heals me when I'm broken.
Heals me when I'm broken.
Today,
my God will heal you when you are broken. No matter the situation, no matter what you are going through, no matter COVID-19, no matter coronavirus, my God will heal you. Lyndon Johnson, my brother. Yes, my prophet, Physician Johnson. Wherever you are, my God will heal you. Yes, no matter where you are. Yes. Yes, he's strengthening you where you have been weak. No matter the situation, no matter what you are going through, no matter what they are saying. Yes, just lift up your hands wherever you are. Just praise him. Awesome. My God is awesome.
Think about it, Savior of the whole world.
Yes. Yes.
By his stripes.
By his stripes. We are healed.
My God is awesome.
My God is awesome.
Today I am forgiven.
Yes, today. You have been forgiven. I have been forgiven. No matter what.
Somebody ought to praise his
holy yes. name. Praise his holy name. My God is awesome.
Come on and lift your
voices
and
say, awesome.
Come on and say, awesome.
Awesome.
My God is awesome. Come on and say, awesome.
Awesome.
Come on and you believe it, lift your voice.
He's mighty.
Awesome.
Yeah, you will testify before this encounter.
He's great.
He's great.
He's great.
He's great.
Awesome.
Hallelujah.
Come on and say.
Awesome.
Come on and say. He's mighty.
Mighty.
He's mighty.
He's mighty.
He's mighty.
He's mighty.
He's mighty.
Awesome.
Everybody say awesome.
Awesome.
Come on and say.
Yes.
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 Awesome.
Awesome.
Holy.
He's holy.
He's holy.
He's holy.
He's holy.
He's holy.
Awesome.
He's my provider. He's your provider. No matter COVID-19, my God will provide for you. You will not lack. He will restore you. He will restore your job. He will restore your finances. He will restore your home. He will restore your family. In the mighty name of Jesus. Yes. He's our protector. He will protect your family. He will protect your family. He will protect your household. He will protect your generation. No matter coronavirus, no matter COVID-19, my God is all. He can move mountains. Yes. Yes. Dr. Achidin, my God will move mountain. Our God will move mountain. He will provide for you no matter what they say. Yes. 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 He's a good God. Yes. His holy name. Let's praise his holy name. Yes, wherever you are, just praise him now. Just praise him. Just glorify him. Just magnify him. Just praise him. Just tell him something good. He said, Lord, I thank you. I am alive. My family is alive. My loved ones are alive. Lord, I thank you because you are providing for us. Lord, we thank you because you have delivered us from COVID-19. Lord, we thank you because you are a good God. What a mighty God you are. What a faithful God you are. In Jesus' merciful name, we have praised. Today, I want us to talk about Christ's death destroyed the power of death. The death of Christ destroyed the power of death. Amen. Let's take our Bible. Let's turn to the book of Revelation chapter 21. Revelation chapter 21. We are going to read from verse 5. Revelation chapter 21, verse 5. If you are there, say amen. If you are not there, still say amen, because we're going to get there. The death of Christ destroyed the power of death. You will not feel this thing no matter what happened, no matter coronavirus, no matter what you have done, no matter your past, no matter what is going on. The death of Christ have destroyed the power of death. You will not feel this thing. Amen. The book of Revelation chapter 21 verse 5. Then who sat on the throne said, behold, I make all things new. And he said to me, write, for those words are true and faithful. Love it. In the book of Isaiah chapter 11 verse 1 to 10, we are told of the Messiah, the mission of the Messiah. On this earth, he will bring justice. He will give decision for the poor. With his breath of his lips, he will slay the wicked in verse 4. He will stand as a banner for the people, and his race, his place will be glorious in verse 10. This will not happen up or anywhere else or in heaven, but it will happen on this earth. The promise that the Messiah has brought unto us, the promise will not be broken. The promise shall be fulfilled. His promise shall not be broken. We all have noticed how Jesus completed his pledge, his words, the things that he said he would do, how he died on the cross on our behalf. We all have seen, we have read, we have heard about the miracles, the signs and wonders that he did. He fulfilled the pledge that he made to mankind on this earth. Those words were not just for one person. It was for the whole world. It was for the entire earth. It was for me and you. No matter where you are, no matter where you go, what you are going through. His words will never return back void. His words will never be broken. And his words are trustworthy. Amen. I want to assure you today that he will come back. No matter the plague, no matter COVID-19, no matter what people are saying, no matter the helter-skelter, no matter the decision the government, lawmakers, people are making, his decision is final. His coming will fulfill. Amen. I just want to encourage everybody. Don't get scared. Don't get carried away. When he comes, no matter where you are, once you have received him as your personal savior, you have accepted him as your personal savior, you will cleave to him. The words
are not only for John or for me or you. You can take those words to the bank and keep them there, stick them there. Those words will come to pass. The words that he spoke, the words that he have given unto us, they shall come to pass. They shall manifest. No matter how long it takes, the word of the Messiah, who is Jesus Christ. He is the only Messiah. There is no other Messiah that is comparable unto him. Neither beside him, neither above him, neither beneath him. Anyone is a fake one. It's not the real one. But brothers and sisters, I want to encourage you. Wherever you are, just hold on unto this Jesus that I know, that we all know. In fact, I have already have and heard all those words. And the words are in the Constitution, Holy Bible. And these words will never fade away. Everything shall fade away, but his words shall never fade away. His words will always stand and will always proceed forth. Just hold on to his words. He's coming. He's here. He's with us. He's around us. He's in our surrounding. Our Messiah is greater. I want to encourage you that no matter what they are saying about your job, about your finances, about your situation, about your home, about your car, about your athlete desire, no matter what is going on, just hold on to Jesus. You will not die because of COVID-19. We shall not die because of coronavirus. Because Christ's death destroyed the power of death. And this is an assurance to us, to me and you, my brothers and sisters. Just hold on to his words. His words are final. Amen. Those are the words that the King of Kings, who is Jesus, have told us. In the book of Ephesians, chapter 1, verse 20. Let's turn to the book of Ephesians, chapter 1, verse 20. Let's go into the book of Ephesians, chapter 1, verse 20. And let's read chapter 1, verse 20. If you are there, say amen. If you are not there, say amen. Which he worked in Christ when he raised him from the dead and set him at his right hand in the heavenly place. Amen. God raised Christ from the dead and set him on his right hand, on the right place. He is sitting there waiting. He is in the same location for me and you. Some people will be asking, where is Christ? Christ is at the right hand of God. The Bible says in the book of Hebrews, chapter 12, verse 2, in terms of his human body, Christ is in one location and only one place. No matter what people are saying, yes, he is still in the same location. He is fixed at the same location, at God's right hand. Jesus is here now, living within us. That's what the Bible says in the book of Galatians, chapter 2, verse 20. If his indwell location is among us, yes, he is. His indwell location is among us. It's among the whole earth. Wherever you go, Jesus Christ is there. Those who are saint and yet sinner now, how much more will he be able to indwell us in this world? To come when no sin shall speak for us. Your sin will not speak for you. Because guess what? He has bound the devil. Because let me tell you something. The Bible tells us that in the book of Revelation, that the accuser of the brethren is the devil. We all know that. Satan is the accuser of the brethren. He will always come and say, you see God, God, you see what he's doing, you see what Brother Francis is doing, you see what Francis is doing, you see what she is doing, you see what John is doing, you see what Brother Abdul is doing. But let me tell you something. Jesus will redeem you. He will deliver you from all sort of sin, from all sort of lies, from all sort of things that mankind have placed on your head. And this morning, I want to encourage you. No matter what they are saying, no matter what they are talking about, Jesus will speak on your behalf. On the new earth, we might. Regularly hear Jesus speaking directly to us in the inward voice. We can hear him. Some will hear the two conversations, no matter where you are, whether you are hundreds of miles away in another part of town or in the New Jerusalem, you will hear Jesus. You will hear his voice. No matter what people say, no matter how far the destination is, no matter how far the length is, you will hear the voice of God. When that time comes, no matter how long it takes, no matter how many years it takes, Jesus will come. The Messiah will come. I want to encourage everybody today that please, my brothers and sisters, get ready for the Messiah. Reframe yourself from your old ways. No matter what you have done, just accept Jesus Christ as your personal Savior. He died for me and you so that we can be free from our sins. So that we can be free for the things that we have been tempted of, the things that we ourselves have, we have got ourselves involved in. He died for us so that sins cannot encapsulate us. Sins cannot hold us down. Sins cannot make us miss heaven. And as for me and my household, I am ready not to miss heaven. I am ready to make eternity, to sit at his feet. If you are ready this morning, this hour, or if you have been ready since the day you were born on this earth, I thank God for your life. And those who are not ready yet, I pray for them, for the Spirit of the Lord to touch them, to encapsulate them wherever they are, so that they can get ready, so that they cannot miss this journey. This earth is not our own. We are just a visitor. We are just a stranger. We are just a passerby. My brothers and sisters, get ready to make that new Jerusalem. If you are ready to make that new Jerusalem and you don't want the death of Jesus Christ to be in vain, my brothers and sisters, just accept him wherever you are this hour, this moment, this day, this morning, this evening, this night. Just call upon him. He said, Lord Jesus, I accept you as my personal Savior. Come into my heart and dwell in me. In Jesus' merciful name, amen. If you can do that prayer and you can ask Jesus to just come and dwell in you, you have made the right decision on this earth. And if you have someone who is not ready yet, don't give up on that person. Continue to pray for them. Continue to intercede on your behalf. Just like the sons of Zebedee, their mother did not give up on them. Their mother went to the Lord Jesus to intercede on their behalf. Although the sons of Zebedee, they knew Jesus, they heard of him, they saw him. They knew, they heard the prophets, they knew what was about to happen. But they did not go to Jesus, but their mother went just to make the new Jerusalem. And I want to urge everyone who is watching me or who can later share this video or hear the words to be articulate, be very, very connected to this new Jerusalem. I don't want you to miss this journey. My brothers and sisters, I want to say again, don't miss this opportunity. Don't miss the sacrifice. There is no man who can sacrifice his only begotten son, who can shed his blood for me and you. There is no man that can do that. Only Jesus and only that blood. There is no other blood that can be sacrificed for me and you. There is no other blood, my brothers and sisters. Any other blood that can be sacrificed for me and you, it's not the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus has been sacrificed 2,000 years ago. And that blood is still speaking. If you believe, just accept that. Jesus, I accept you so that I can make the new Jerusalem. I accept the death that destroyed the power of death. I just want to pray with you today. Wherever you are, you say, Lord God Almighty, I pray for my brothers and sisters, wherever they are, Father. Let the blood of Jesus continue to speak for us. Father, even the frontliners, the health workers, the firefighters, the police officers, the responders, the doctors, the government workers, the lawmakers that are fighting this vicious disease that is not a respecter of a man. Father, continue to guide them and protect them, O God Almighty. Father, deliver them. Father, O God Almighty, let the blood of Jesus saturate the whole earth. Let the blood of Jesus purify the whole earth. Let the blood of Jesus deliver us, O God Almighty, and deliver our nation and restore our nation. In the mighty name of Jesus, my Father, my God, let the blood of Jesus continue to speak for us. No matter where we are, no matter where the government is, the government might be in Washington, might be in the State House, might be in the Parliament, might be in Azure, wherever the governments are. Father, let the blood of Jesus speak on the masses' behalf, on the nation's behalf, and let the blood of Jesus continue to deliver us. In Jesus' precious name, amen, amen, and amen. God bless you, my brothers and sisters.